In this segment, we're going to take an example of the exponential model of regression. So we have an exponential model which we want to be able to use for regressing to a particular data. And what we're going to do is we're going to use transform data. We're going to use transform data to do so. I will talk about a little bit later about what the transform data means. In the previous segment, I already talked the theory about using the transform data to develop the exponential model. So let's talk about the example. The example is about an isotope of technetium, which is used for gallbladder scanning. And an isotope, technetium 99M isotope, is used to be able to do a CT scan of a gallbladder. Now, as we know that this is a radioactive material, so we want to be able to figure out that how long does it take for a person to lose this isotope from the body. The half-life of technetium-99m is about 6 hours, so it doesn't take too long for one to go back to the normal levels of radiation which we get from the sun, for example. So, but let's go and see, figure out for ourselves that if we take the intensity of the isotope versus time data, will we be able to figure out that how much of the isotope is still in the body? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you time, which is in hours, versus relative intensity data. So that's relative intensity. What I mean by relative intensity is that this is the intensity of the isotope when related to what is happening at 0 hours. So what that means is that at zero, the relative intensity will be, of course, 1, because you're dividing by the intensity at time t equals 0. At other points, the data is given to us. At 1, it is 0.891. At 3, it is 0.708. At 5, it is 0.562. At 7, it is 0.447. At 9, it is 0.355. So you're only seeing that around about 6 hours or so, you're losing about half of it. So the half-life is of technetium-99m actually is 6 hours. But let's go and figure out that what happens, what is the relative intensity at 24 hours? Does it go down very low so that the patient is not worried about having radioactive material in their bodies? So what we're going to do is we are going to use the exponential model to be able to figure out what the relative intensity of the technetium isotope is at 24 hours. So we're going to use the exponential model to do the regression. So, but we're going to use the transform data for this. So what that means is that if I have gamma is equal to A e to the power bt, I'm going to transform the data corresponding to this model so that I can use the linear regression formulas. So what does that mean is that I'm going to take the log of both sides, for example, in this case. That's how I'll be able to do the transformation of the data so that I can use the linear regression model. So I get log of gamma is equal to log of A plus BT. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this to be my Z. I'm going to assume this to be my A naught, this to be my A1. That's what I'm going to take, do those substitutions. So if I look at those substitutions, I get Z is equal to A0 plus A1 times T. That's what I'm getting. Now, this is a linear relationship between Z and T. As you can see, that it's a straight line or a first-order polynomial relationship between Z and T. Now, what that means is that if I'm able to find Z versus T data, then I'll be able to find A0 and A1. So if I'm able to find A0 and A1, then I can find my log A and B, which B is same as A1, while log of A is equal to A naught, so A would be equal to A naught. So that means that, let's suppose, for example, once I find A naught, log of A is A naught, so A will be e to the power A naught. So that's how I'll be able to find my A. And B is nothing but the value of A1. So that's how I'll be able to find the constants of the exponential model. Keep in again mind that the linear relationship is between Z and T. So in no way should you consider that we are linearizing the model. We're not linearizing the model. All we are doing is transforming the data itself so that there's a linear relationship between Z and T, not between gamma and T, not between the relative intensity and time. It's an exponential model. We are developing, trying to see if there's a linear relationship between Z and T, and from that we can backtrack the constants of the exponential model, which are a and b. So as you can see, that z is going to log of gamma, which means that what we'll have to do is we'll have to take all the individual gamma values and calculate our zi values to be able to do that. Now, how do I find a naught and a1 of this? A1 will be equal to n times summation zi t sub I minus summation zi summation t sub I divided by n times summation t sub I square minus summation t sub I whole square. So that's the coming from the linear regression formulas. That's what I'm going to use. All these summations are going from 1 to n, so that's why I've not put the limits of the summation here. I should have, but all the limits of the summation are 1 to n, where n is the number of data points which I have. And a naught is nothing but z bar minus a1 t bar, where z bar is the average value of the z values, and t bar is the average value of the t values. So that's how I'll be able to find a1 and a0 from the z versus t data. And then I'll be able to find a and b, which are the constants of the exponential model, from the values of a0 and a1, which I find from the linear regression formulas here. So I'm going to draw a table so that I can calculate these zi values, which are the values which I need from the original data. So I'm going to calculate the ZI values, and then also I'm going to develop a table so that I can show the summations which I need. I need the summation of Z sub I, T sub I, summation of Z sub I, summation of T sub I, and summation of T sub I squared. That's what I need. So let's go and draw a table for that and be able to see that how can we get all these summations together. So we have T sub I here. We have gamma I here. These are the data points which are already given to us. So I'm going to repeat those, 0, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So these are all which are given to us, these data values which I'm writing, 0, 1, 0.891, 0.708, 0.562, 0.447, and 0.355. So these values are already given to me as gamma versus t data. But as I know that in order to be able to use my linear regression formulas, I need to calculate my z sub I, which is nothing but the log of the gamma values. So that's basically taking the natural log of these numbers that will give me the zi values. And those turn out to be 0, minus 0.1154, minus 0.3453, minus 0.5763, minus 1.0356, and minus, and that's about it. 234. I think I skipped a number here. It's minus 0.8052 and minus 1.0356. So those are the transformed ZI values now, which I need. And then, of course, I need TI times ZI. I need that. And I also need T sub I square, because these are all needed for the summation. So T sub I, Z sub I will be simply the multiplication of the T value which I have and the Z value which I have. So for example, the first one will be 0, the second one will be 1 times minus 0.1154, next time will be 3 times this number here, which turns out to be minus 1.0359, then I get minus 2.8813, minus 5.6364, minus 9.3207. So those are the multiplication of the T and Z values. And then the last column is simply the square of the T values, which I need for the summation. So that would be 0, 1, 9, 25, 49, and 81. So what I need for the formula, for the linear regression formula, are the summations of T sub I's, which is this, and that turns out to be 25. Now, I don't need the summation of gamma i's because I'm using the transform data. I need the summation of the ZI values, which turns out to be minus 2.8778. Summation of the TI ZI values, all of these values added together, gives you minus 18.98 97. And the summation of all the TI values here gives me 165. So I have all the summations which I need to be able to use the formula for calculating A0 and A1 of the transformed data so that I can use the linear regression formula. So what that means that A1, I'm going to use the A1 formula. A1 is N, which is how many data points do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 data points. Summation of the ZITI values, that is this, minus 18.9897. And then minus the summation of the ZI values, which is right here, that's minus 2.8778. And summation of the TI values, which is 25, which is right here, divided by N, which is again 6, times the summation of the TI square value, which is 165, minus the summation of TI values, which is 25, and square of that. And that number here turns out to be equal to minus 0.1150. That's the value of A1 which I get for the Z is equal to A0 plus A1T linear regression line. And similarly, I'll find A0. A0 is nothing but Z bar minus A1 times T bar. Now, Z bar values are simply the average of the Z values which I have, 2.8878 divided by 6. That's the summation of Z sub I. We have 6 values, minus A1, which I just found, minus 0.1150, times the average value of T value, which is 25, divided by 6. 25 is the summation of the T values, and there are 6 T values. And this A0 here turns out to be minus 0.00022. 6, 1, 5. That's what I get for A0. So basically what I have is of the transformed data which I for which I use linear regression formulas, Z is equal to A0 plus A1T, I get A0 is equal to minus 0.0002615. I get A1 equal to minus 0.1150. But these are the constants of the linear regression model of Z versus T. What I need to find out is what are the constants of the exponential model, where Z is equal to A e to the power BT. We already established that A is nothing but e to the power A naught. So that's e to the power A naught, which is this number here, minus 0.0002615. And that turns out to be 0.9997. And then if you look at A, B is nothing but A1. B is nothing but A1, and A1 turns out to be nothing but whatever this number A1 is, minus 0.1150. So what you have been able to do is by transforming the data, you have been able to find the constants of the exponential model A and B. This is the exponential model which you have where the relationship between relative intensity and time is given. So based on the values of A and B, which I have found out, I have been able to find the constant of the regression model. So the regression model is R is gamma is equal to 0.9997 e to the power minus 0.1150 t. And what we're interested in the beginning was, hey, what is the value of the relative intensity at 24? So all I would do is just put in the value of 24 for my time, and I would be able to find out what the value of the relative intensity is. And it turns out to be 0.0632. So what that means is that only 6% of the isotope which was injected in this person 24 hours ago is left. And this is very mild, because it's almost the same kind of radiation which we get in everyday life from the sun and other radioactive materials. So we should not be worried about that after 24 hours that he has still 6% of the isotope in his body. Now, what I would like you to do as homework is as follows, because we know that the relative intensity at time t equals 0 is 1, because we are measuring the relative intensity corresponding to time t equals 0. What I would like you to do is, since we know that we used gamma is equal to e to the power bt as our regression model, let's go simply use gamma is equal to e to the power bt. Because we know that at time t equal to 1, a is 1. So if you want to force the relative intensity to be 1 at time t equals 0, then the regression model which you're supposed to use is this. There's only one constant of the regression model, which is b. So I would like you to go ahead and take the same data and regress it to gamma is equal to e to the power bt. And that's the end of the segment.